So we're in the electrical workshop. It's my absolute pleasure to be joined by Emilio, and it's monsoon season, so no doubt you'll hear the rain pitter-pattering on the roof. One of your learners, Emilio, has produced this rig for us, but what are we going to look at today?
So basically today, guys, we've got a radial socket circuit here.
Yes.
Which is feeding a switch fuse spur, which allows us to spur off that into a lighting circuit.
Right, okay, so let's play that back. So I've got a socket circuit at home. This one's an A3 radial. However, it could be a ring final circuit. And you're telling me from a socket circuit, I can install a lighting point.
That's right, yeah.
Where would I maybe look to use this in order that I had a socket and maybe I want a light? What sort of locations would that be in?
So for example, if you in your garage, your shed, if you have a socket there, you can spur off the socket into a switch fuse spur and then install a light.
Okay, well, let's break down the circuit and look at some of the cables and see if I can catch you out. So we've got a 2.5 millimeter squared cable here feeding the socket outlet.
That's right.
One or more if it's an A3 radio. We've only got one on this little test rig. What size cable is it here going into the fuse connection unit?
So we also have a 2.5 cable feeding the switch fuse spur.
Okay.
And that will go into the in terminal or supply.
Okay. And I've got a funny feeling that is not 2.5 Emilio coming out of it. What size cable is that?
So there we have a 1mm cable.
Yes.
The reason we can use a 1mm cable and not 2.5 is because we've derated the fuse to a 3-amp cartridge fuse.
So that's in here?
No, it's in here.
So you've replaced the 13-amp standard. We'll be checking that at some point. We've replaced the 13-amp standard fuse that comes in a switch fuse connection unit, and you've replaced that with a 3-amp fuse.
Yep.
Okay, and that means that we can go out in 1mm squared cable to feed our lights.
Yeah.
I quite like the thinking behind that. So let's say that this light here was maybe an outside light, a garage light, whatever it is. It requires a little bit of maintenance, so we can see it's clearly working now. But let's say we needed to replace it or maintain it. How am I going to go about that?
Okay, so if you wanted to change the fitting,
yeah,
you could isolate the light from this switch here. So if I just switch it off there, see okay. The light's gone off.
Okay.
So then to isolate it securely and safely, you can undo this screw here.
Yes, this little screw
here. And
this
insert comes out, pop out the fuse, and a little padlock to lock it off nice and safely.
So that means I could leave every socket on in the installation.
Yep.
Maybe it's in the shed, but every socket can be left on.
Mm-hmm.
I can change the light fitting because I'm not going to perform the safe isolation at my 20-amp circuit breaker.
That's right.
I'm going to perform my safe isolation at the fuse connection.
At the fuse spur, yep.
I quite like that. I think we're going to bring the camera in a little bit closer. I think you're going to show me that you've got a 3-amp fuse, which I'm skeptical about. So you're going to show me that 3-amp fuse. We'll perhaps lock it off, and then shall we use our approved voltage indicator and prove that the supply is isolated?
Yep.
So we just swung the camera in a little closer. We've isolated the double pole switch here on the switch fuse connection unit, but you said to me you're going to remove this fuse as part of the isolation process. We've seen the light go off.
Yep.
Can you just open that up for me, Emilio?
Yep, so we're going to use this key to open this set here.
Okay.
It's a quarter of a turn.
Okay.
I'll try and keep my hands out of the way.
Yeah, it's always difficult to get out of the way of the camera. Everyone says, oh, I don't know how you do it.
Let's
try and out the way out of the camera.
Then we'll use this side just to lick it open.
Okay, so you've got that. Trying to keep yourself out of the way of the tripod.
Okay. There we go.
Oh, that looks red. Is it a 3-amp?
And then just to prove, I'll get this out.
Okay.
It's a 3-amp fuser, BS1362.
Okay, so we've got the BS1362 3-amp fuser, so you prove yourself right. Okay.
Yep.
Emilio's giving me a masterclass off camera. There's a little hole up here. I'm going to attempt from behind the tripod in order to put a padlock and a sign through here. So if you want to pass me it, thank you, Emilio.
Yep.
So here we go. Can I do it with a tripod in the way? So there's a little hole at the top here, which I've got to get through. I've got it through there. And then I just clip the two together and hopefully I've secured the isolation there. Can I push it back into place? I can't. And there's no fuse in the carrier either. So I've got my sign on it. I've safely isolated here, and Emilio's going to show us now how to prove it's dead at the actual lighting point itself. Remember to keep the keys from the padlock on yourself at all times. So before we use our approved voltage indicator, Emilio, what are you going to do?
So we're just going to make sure the voltage indicator's still working.
Okay.
So we're just going to probe it into the proving unit.
Okay, brilliant. It's been flying around in the back of the van, and I can tell you from my side, all good. So we just proved our voltage indicator is working correctly. Can you prove now that actually the circuit is not live for me, Emilio?
Yeah, sure. So we're going to probe onto the least dangerous conductor first, which is the CPC.
Okay.
And then onto the line conductor.
Okay. And that's got 0 volts.
Zero volts. So off the line, off the CPC. Now I'm going to go between the CPC and the neutral conductor.
Okay, yeah, 0 volts.
0 volts off the neutral.
Okay, good.
Off the CPC. And that leaves us with the neutral and a line conductor.
Okay, so onto the neutral first. Okay, brilliant.
Yep.
And then onto the line conductor, 0 volts.
Yep.
And then we're off the line conductor and off neutral. Brilliant. So are you happy that that circuit now is isolated, Emilio?
Yep, pretty happy with that.
Oh, we got one more thing we've got to do with our voltage indicator before we fully confirm it?
Yeah, we've got to test it again.
Okay.
In the proving unit.
So then, before we're 100% comfortable that we've isolated this circuit, what are we going to do?
So we have to prove the voltage indicator is still working after we've isolated the supply.
Okay.
So I'm probing into the voltage, the proving unit.
Okay, and I can tell you from my side, everything's good.
Cool.
So I found that fascinating. This is an exercise that Emilio uses to stretch his more able learners at level one and level two. Just go back through some of those key points that they should have got from the exercise for me, please.
Yeah, so here they have a socket circuit here, which have spurred off into a switch fuse spur with a 3-amp cartridge fuse, which has allowed us to install a lighting circuit here.
So the learners that have done basic lighting circuits and basic socket circuits have actually brought the learning from both of them together to utilise the socket circuit in order to have a light on it.
That's right.
We also went on and looked at the safe isolation procedure, which didn't require us to isolate it in the consumer unit. Where did we end up isolating it?
So we don't need to isolate it at the consumer unit. We can isolate it here with the switch fuse spur.
And the advantage of that meant that every socket in the installation was left on as we repaired that outside
line. That's right.